Number 67, play the circle game. If you use my 4-minute, 4-circle, goal-setting system described earlier, you can be the creator of your universe. You know, that's blasphemous, a seminar student once told me during a break. Only God can create the universe. But if you believe that, I said, you must also believe as it is written. That we were all created in God's image. And if you believe in God as the creator, and that he created us in his image. Then what are we doing when we don't create? Whose image are we living in when we deliberately do not create? Try this, after you wake up in the morning. Wipe the sleep from your eyes, sit down with a pad of paper, and draw 4 circles. These are your own planets. Label the first circle, lifelong dream. And in order to keep this example simple, I'll make it strictly financial, although you can do it with any kinds of goals you want. Your lifelong dream might be to save $500,000 for your retirement years. So, put that number in your life circle. Then look at circle 2, the next planet in your solar system. That circle you will label, my year. What do you need to save in the next year in order to be on course to hit your life savings goal? When you factor in the interest, it's less than you think. And when you arrive at the figure, make certain that it matches up mathematically with your first circle. In other words, if you save this amount, and save, say 10% more each year that follows, will you achieve your life number? If not, do some more math until you get a direct connection between your yearly savings projection and your lifelong goal. Now that you've got your first 2 circles filled with a number, move to the 3rd circle. My month. What would you have to save each month to hit your year's goal? Then put that number down. 3 circles are now filled. Now go to the final circle, my day. What do you need to do today, that if you repeated it every day, would ensure a successful month? By the way, as I said, this doesn't have to just be about money. It can be about physical fitness, learning a language, relationship networking, spirituality, nutrition, or anything important to you. The power of this system lies in thinking of it as a universe. Which, as Wayne Dyer keeps reminding us, means, one song. When you work the math, you cannot help but see that each circle, if done successfully, guarantees the success of the next circle. If you hit your daily goal every day, your monthly goal is automatically hit. In fact, you don't even have to worry about it. And if your monthly goal is reached, the yearly goal has to happen. And if your yearly goals are hit, the lifelong goal cannot not be reached. When you study the irrefutable mathematical truth contained in this system, a strange feeling comes over you. You realize that all 4 circles are ultimately dependent on the success of just 1 circle, the circle labeled, my day. Then you get the strangely empowering sensation that you have just proved on paper that your day and your life are the same thing. There is no future other than the future you are working on today. Your future is not stranded out there somewhere in space. This is what the great poet Rainer Maria Rilke meant when he said, the future enters into us, in order to transform itself in us, long before it happens. Remember that once you have worked out the math for this, the circle game is only a 4-minute daily exercise. Many times in seminars I give, participants will say that they are too busy for all this goal-setting activity. They have lives to live. But I like to remind them of the words of Henry Ford, who said, if you do not think about the future, you won't have one. And I also like to stress that I am only talking about 4 minutes a day. The purpose of making the circles mathematically sound is that you can remove the elements of faith and hoping from your action plan. You know your goals will be hit. Who would you want to bet on? The tennis player who has faith that she's going to win, or the one who knows she's going to win? By drawing these simple 4 circles, you can create your universe anywhere, anytime. Waiting in line at the bank, sitting in the doctor's office, waiting for a meeting to begin, or just doodling. Each time you do it, your universe gets closer to you. Each time you draw the circles, you are hit with this revelation. There is absolutely no difference between succeeding today and having a successful life. In The Magic of Believing, Claude Bristol recounts a particularly absent-minded habit of his that, looking back, may have had a bigger impact on shaping his universe than he ever realized. He said that whether he was on the phone, or just sitting in moments of abstraction, he would always have a pen or pencil out doodling. My doodling was in the form of dollar signs like these, dollar 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 dollar, on every paper that came across my desk. The cardboard covers of all the files that were placed before me daily were covered with these markings. So were the covers of telephone directories, scratch pads, and even the face of important correspondence. Bristol's later studies on mind stuff experiments, the power of suggestion, and the art of mental pictures caused him to conclude that his lifelong habit of doodling dollar signs had had an enormous impact on programming his mind to always be opportunistic and enterprising when it came to money. The fortune he acquired demands that we take his observations seriously.
Thanks for watching. Are you visiting our channel for the first time? Then click subscribe and hit that thumbs up below the video. Join us for more videos like this.